never knew his full name. He just drifted into town one day. But he became quite well known around about where I lived, 'cause he always seemed to end up in the middle of every fight that somebody started. Never seemed to be completely sober, and he had a knack for being the butt of everybody's joke. I can't recall that he ever worked, and he just was always hanging around. But something happened to old John, and it has a lot to do with this song. He started going to church. At least that was a rumor about town. Well, I couldn't imagine old John getting cleaned up in the first place, much less being seen in church. Me? Now, I'm not specially proud of some of the things I did myself back in those days, but old John, well, old John just wasn't the kind I thought to be taken up with church folks. So Sunday night I went down to the church myself just to see if he was there. I stood outside and looked in, and sure enough, there he was, right next to the window, singing away. And I'll tell you, the expression on his face was something to see. He seemed to be looking right into the face of Jesus Christ himself. And oh, the way that he was singing. After that, I never saw old John hanging around the old places anymore. And when I did see him, he had a different kind of look on his face. Then I didn't see him for a while, and one day one of the boys I knew said, "Hey, are you going to the funeral?" Naturally, I said, "What funeral?" "Well," he said, "old John died day before yesterday, and they're having his funeral this afternoon." I didn't really think seriously about going, but then I started wondering if anybody would be there. After all, I'd never known him to have any real friends, and so more out of curiosity than anything else, I went. Well, I couldn't believe my eyes. There were people all over the place. I managed to squeeze just inside the front door so that I could see. The funeral was just about over. The preacher stood up and said something like this: "Now all of us learned to love Brother John very much during the time that he was with us. And out of respect to his memory and his testimony, I suggest that we stand together and sing his favorite song, 'Oh, How I Love Jesus.'" Now I'd always pictured funerals as being kind of sad and morbid, but this one, well, this one was different. Those people made that old song sound like an anthem of joy, and I could feel a strange kind of stirring inside my own heart. Because he first loved me. Time went by, but I could never quite forget old John and that funeral that didn't really seem like a funeral. Something seemed to be telling me that maybe old John had found something I didn't know about. Anyway, one evening I went down to the church and slipped inside over next to the window. The kindly old gentleman sitting behind me asked, "Did you know Brother John?" I said, "Yes, sir, somewhat." He said, "Well, you know, you're sitting in his favorite spot. Folks here thought of him mighty highly." I don't recall too much what the preacher preached on, except that he talked about the love of God and about how he could give us what we didn't have in our lives if we could just trust him and love him. It was so simple. He finished and the choir began very softly singing that song, "Oh, How I Love Jesus." Standing there, I felt that strange stirring in my heart again. And then I suddenly realized old John had found something I didn't have and had never had. He had changed old John into something worth loving and made him a better man than I was. And then I knew I wanted to know the same Jesus that old John knew. I wanted his God to be my God too. I saw that if Jesus Christ could take something like old John and change him, he could do the same thing for me. And he did. Right there on my knees, I found the greatest joy I'd ever known. I felt a peace come into my heart I never knew I could have. And I learned there, and I still know why old John loved to sing that song so much, because I love Jesus too. His love is great, and there's nothing like it.
Because he first loved me.